Hi, how you doing there, folks? Okay, this article appeared in today's New York Post. It's in today's New York Post, Monday, October 12, 2009, kid killed in DWI horror. Okay, this didn't have to happen, folks. First of all, this woman was at a party and she's driving all seven kids over to her house in the Bronx for a slumber party. Okay, Monday, October 12, 2009, appeared in pages 4 and 5. This is similar to the case where Diane Schuler, she was driving while she was drunk, went the wrong way in the Taconic Parkway, you know, went the wrong way, got into an accident, killed herself, and I believe three, four other kids, including her daughter, and critically injuring her son. Okay, now as far as this one over here, this could have been prevented. The people at the party should not have allowed her to drive while drunk. They should not have even allowed her to even leave the place while she was drunk. She had a alcohol test, blood alcohol level 0.13. More than 1.5 times the legal limit. Now, 12:30 is when she left. 12:30 a.m., I believe, would ever be Sunday night. Okay, this is Monday's paper. You know what? All she had to do was just wait 1 hour. 1 hour. And half of the alcohol would have been out of her body. That's it. All you had to do was wait 1 hour. It's on the driver's. It's on the test you take. You know, the written test when you go to get a driver's license. In 1 hour, half of alcohol goes out of your system. Okay? Waited 1 hour and 40 minutes, drank 2 Cokes. She would not have been drunk. And then everything would have been fine. You know? Now as far as this could have been prevented, now this father whose daughter was killed, her daughter asked for permission to go with this woman over to the slumber party at her house. I believe her name was the Wendy Rosado. That's the girl that was killed. The drunken driver was her mother herself and her kids. She was driving 7 kids. Her name was Carmen Huerta. Okay? Now, first of all, rule number one is that from what I could interpret, this whole thing could have been prevented. No parent, any parties is drinking associated with it. Just even the word party. There's going to be drinking, you know. Yeah, sure. Now, so that's what says in the paper, at 8:30, she didn't appear drunk. No, she wouldn't have appeared drunk then, because the party is just beginning. Left at 9:30 a.m., one of the other parents that had a daughter that was in her car when it overturned. At 9:30, she didn't appear drunk, because she would not have been drunk at that time. You're talking about between 9:30 and 12:30, there probably was at least 6 beers that were drank. If not shots of vodka and all that. So, rule number one, how this guy could have avoided his daughter being killed, is number one, you don't allow any of your kids to go into a vehicle with someone that you don't really know. Number one. And number two, and for sure, not to be driven from a party, unless you actually were there watching the person that's going to be driving to see what she was doing, how much if she was drunk or not, how much liquor drinking, it's a whole bunch of things, you know. The way to play it safe is don't allow your kids to go into any vehicles where any other people that you don't really know. You know, unless it's a friend, but you know for sure that there's no drinking. Coming from a party, it's almost certain it's going to be drinking. You know, same thing like with Diane Schuler, that was a little bit different. Still the same same thing, this could have been prevented. This could have been prevented, folks. Now, I'm making this video. The reason I'm making this video is because I'm just hoping that if this video manages just to stop one kid from being killed the same way, from me having to read another horror story in the New York Post, Daily News, or New York Times, this video is worth $1 million, if it so much as saves one life, you know? First of all, just to make it plain bluntly, you don't drink and drive. Query. Friend, you ever seen the commercial? Friends kill other friends when they let friends drink and drive? Well, that's it. This is exactly what happens. You get in a car while you're drunk. This is exactly what's going to end up happening. I'm going to show you right here. I'm going to show you what ends up happening when you drink and drive. This is what happens. That's it. You know? And depending on how bad the crash is, or if seatbelts were worn, the results could end up being maimed for life, or even killed. So, what the whole damn thing is, just don't get in a vehicle after you've been drinking. For at least 1 or 2 hours after, or 3 hours, you know? How many times have I read this in the paper, the horror stories, that could have been prevented? Another one was around 2002, 2003, 2004. It was around that time, an officer coming off of work in Brooklyn ran over a whole family around 6:30 in the morning on Sunday. Then there was another story in the New York area newspapers about a week ago about he also was an off-duty officer, and he ran over a woman. You see, this could be prevented. It's simple. Don't drink while driving. And then the traffic laws got to be changed. The penal code has to be changed. That if you run over somebody, and you kill someone, and you were drunk, or the vehicle goes on the sidewalk and kills a pedestrian, you should be charged with murder. None of this manslaughter garbage. You should be charged with murder, because you murdered the person. The whole thing is, if the weapon's a car, let's say you're not drunk, if the weapon's a car, you run over someone and kill someone, you could just say, I just got my foot caught between the brake and the gas pedal, and you're off. Scot-free, folks. Same thing like with the Crown Heights thing. When that kid got killed, to spark the Crown Heights riots. Oh, I just got my foot caught between the gas pedal and the brake. Oh, you're off. You're don't worry, it was an accident. But meanwhile, the person is killed, the life is gone. You run over someone, you kill somebody, should be charged with murder. Murder, and that's plain and simple.